Known as Arthur Curry and Orin, the hero Aquaman has been a staple character in the DC universe for just so long now. As the king of Atlantis and other undersea territories, he technically controls most of the planet, which is insane to think about considering how much he gets made fun of in the superhero community. Now, you've probably heard of his bigger enemies like Black Manta and the Ocean Master, but like so many other heroes, Aquaman has his fair share of villains. What is going on, all you nerdy folk out there? My name is Jack, and welcome back to Top 10 Nerd. Today, we're going to be taking a look at DC's hero who always seems to be the butt of the joke, Aquaman, and some of the lesser-known villains on his roster that he has gone up against since his debut in 1959's Adventure Comics. Some are great, and some are not so much, so let's just get right into it. Number 10, Wacky Man. Although not inherently evil, this unnamed clown of a man is still considered to be an Aquaman villain. Wacky Man was a clown that used robotic versions of aquatic creatures in his act, and because of that, he decided to model his costume after Aquaman's. He was actually a pretty decent clown, bringing in people from all over to see his act. However, this wasn't always the best thing, because he eventually caught the attention of some pirates who kidnapped him and forced him to use his robotic sea creatures to not only commit crimes, but to go after the real Aquaman. He proved to be someone who was not truly evil though, because once freed from the pirates, he teamed up with Aquaman to take them down. Check him out in his only appearance in 1957's Adventure Comics number 233, and let me know in the comments below if you think he truly deserves to be considered a villain for that. Number 9, Clownfish. Sidney Allard was once a doctor with a pretty shady practice. He was killing his elderly patients and just covering it up as much as he could. After part of San Diego sank, Allard was recruited by Black Manta and was tasked with taking blood samples of every resident in now Sub Diego. This included Aquaman, Aquagirl, and Cal Durham. After those three were rescued, Allard slipped away seamlessly and started looting a room full of chemicals. However, he stumbled a little bit and ended up breaking a vial that contained a strain of the Joker toxin. Engulfed in the toxin, Allard completely lost his sanity, took inspiration from a fish in a bowl, and colored his entire body purple and yellow, and then from then on dubbed himself the Clown Fish. He then decided to break into Cal Durham's home and shoot his partner Kaisa Salton with a mini harpoon, and then strapped a bomb to her torso. Obviously, Aquaman arrived on the scene to save Kaisha, but Allard seemed to be prepared for that because he was somehow able to make Aquaman take a truth serum drug so that he could find a way to get rid of him for good. Thankfully, Aquaman was able to sober up before he answered any questions though. Having failed, Allard pushes the trigger for the bomb, however, it's revealed that the one strapped to Kaisha was a fake, and the real one was hidden under the couch. Now, everyone was saved by Aquaman before the explosion, and Clownfish made a clean getaway. Check out his story for yourself, starting with his first appearance in 2007's Aquaman, Sword of Atlantis. Number 8, The Awesome Threesome. Known together as the Awesome Threesome, Torpedo Man, Claw, and Magneto, but not the one that you're thinking of, were a team of robotic villains who went up against Aquaman and his Aqua family. Debuting in 1967's Aquaman Volume 1 Number 36, this villainous team was telepathically summoned to attack a science hall, but it turns out they picked the wrong day to do it though, because Aquaman, Mera, Aqualad, and Aquababy were all visiting the pavilion and sprung into action the moment they heard all the commotion. Magneto destroyed the gyromolecularizer, which was trapping a convicted alien on Earth for 5,000 years. With the molecularizer destroyed, the alien was free to escape and release his control on the robots. The threesome was apprehended quickly, however the alien escaped to Atlantis and began causing some serious damage to the city. It was able to then make a quick getaway thanks to a flying saucer, and once away, it then released its mind control from the three robots once again, and they were back to their old villainous selves. Check out this robotic team of villains for yourself in their first appearance in 1967's Aquaman Volume 1, Number 36. Number 7, Fisherman. An international criminal who started off as a thief who would steal anything he could get his hands on and sell them to the highest bidder. He came in contact with Aquaman after stealing a formula that could enlarge any living matter, and ever since then, the two have been enemies. Fast forward a little bit and we see the fisherman clash with Aquaman on multiple occasions, each time ending in his defeat, and he eventually takes up residence in the villain-friendly country of Zandia. That was, however, just the first iteration of the fisherman, however, because there have been a few fishermen over the years, and that's because he is actually a parasite that takes over a host and forces them to commit crimes and do his bidding. The second iteration attacked the Gotham police during the Infinite Crisis alongside Scavenger, Red Pansy, and Riddler, and was shot down by Marcus Driver. And the third was actually just an imposter fisherman that was revealed to be a xenoform parasite that controlled its host using fear. Take a look at this character for yourself, starting with their first appearance in 1965's Aquaman number 21. Number 6, Human Flying Fish. One day, way back in the day, Victor Bragg and Dr. Krill saw Aquaman using his fish telepathy to catch a bunch of baddies. Krill turned to Bragg and convinced him to undergo a special operation to turn him into a human flying fish, because Krill believed that Aquaman would not be able to stop him from that. With his newfound abilities of enhanced speed, flight, and ability to breathe underwater, Bragg was able to outperform Aquaman and escape on every mission he was sent out on. It took a little bit, but Aquaman was eventually able to figure out Bragg's tactics and devise a plan to trap him. Luring him in with a rumor of a bounty of uranium that was somewhere lost at sea, he took the bait and attempted to find it. The human flying fish was then taken out by Aquaman using electric eels, and he alongside Dr. Krill were arrested and taken away. Bragg was later seen as a criminal for hire, but was taken out rather quickly by Joseph Curry, the new Aquaman, and honestly hasn't really been seen since. Take a look at his story for yourself, starting with his first appearance in 1960s Adventure Comics number 272. Number 5. Animal Master. Gustav was just once a regular old animal trainer who made a pretty decent living traveling the world as a circus performer. Like many other performers though, fame and fortune started to get to his head and it got to a point where he began training his animals to commit crimes for him. Having been able to escape the cops on most heists, he began to get cocky and decided to escape by boat, and then this allowed Aquaman to enter the scene. However, he wasn't able to catch him this time around. This was both a blessing in disguise and a curse for Gustav because although he escaped, a terrible storm hit the area and completely destroyed his boat. Presumed to be dead by everyone including Aquaman, Gustav was actually very much alive and had found his way to a desert island where he tirelessly trained the animals he found on the island so he could enact his revenge on Aquaman. He was eventually able to lure Aquaman to his island, but he couldn't beat him and that ended in his arrest. Check out Animal Master for yourself in his first appearance in 1959's Adventure Comics number 261. Number 4. Laren. Residing in the realm known as Dimension Aqua, Laren possesses pretty much all the powers you would expect from Aquaman, just toned down a fair amount. Long ago, he led a revolt against the Queen Mera and forced her to flee to Earth, which is kind of a good thing because that's where she met Aquaman. Laren ended up following her and was able to capture Aquaman and Aqualad and brought them back to Dimension Aqua as prisoners. Thankfully, Aquaman was able to figure out a plan of action pretty quickly and he alongside Mera and the rest were able to escape back to Atlantis, which just solidified Laren's position as the new ruler of the Dimension Aqua. A few years later, Mera ended up returning to Dimension Aqua and had discovered that Laren had gotten rid of all of her tools and tossed them into the Great Pit. This forced her to go toe-to-toe with Laren and she was able to overpower him, shattering his mind in the process, leaving him completely and utterly useless. If you feel like it, give this villain's story a read for yourself, starting with his first appearance in 1963's Aquaman, number 11. Number 3. Captain Demo. Although his real identity is unknown, Captain Demo is a high-tech underwater pirate whose crew specializes in using very deadly and very experimental weaponry. Demo drives a fully functioning 16th century pirate ship that somehow works perfectly underwater, and of course when you drive a 16th century ship, you have to dress the part. It's also not really explained how, but he and his crew are able to breathe perfectly underwater without the need for scuba gear or anything like that. Deciding one day to conquer Atlantis, he managed to rig the entire city to explode unless Aquaman submitted to him, to which he complied and ended up doing some truly terrible things. When he finally got the chance, Aquaman turned on Demo and knocked him out cold in a one-on-one fist fight. Topo the Octopus also helped out and he took out the majority of Demo's men, however enough of them were able to band together and rescue their captain so that they could live to fight another day. Check out Captain Demo for yourself, starting with his first appearance in 1975's Adventure Comics number 441. Number 2. Scavenger. Peter Mortimer was a deep sea diver and pirate who dubbed himself the Scavenger because, you know, he scavenges. With no real powers, he operated an advanced submersible vessel called the Scorpion Ship and plundered the seas. Hearing rumors of an alien artifact called the Time Decelerator, Mortimer traveled to Atlantis and confronted Aquaman about it because he believed that it was capable of making him immortal. He kidnapped Mera and Aqua Baby and poisoned the water in Atlantis, forcing Aquaman to help him find this new mysterious device. Funnily enough, he actually did end up finding the device, however, upon activating it, it regressed him in age until he stopped existing completely, forcing him to live in a limbo-like state for many, many years. He eventually was able to somehow make it back to his original age and size, and teamed up with Cobra for a while upon his return. Scavenger is later seen to have reformed and even becomes friends with Aquaman. Their last battle was over stolen cargo that turned out to be vaccines. Mortimer's conscience got the better of him and he was treated like a hero for the very first time as he helped deliver them safely. Aquaman helped him clean up his act and he even became a business owner. There's a little bit more to the story that gets just, you know, a little bit risque, so if you're feeling up to it, I'll let you check that out for yourself. So give his story a read, starting with his first appearance in 1968's Aquaman number 37. And number 1, King Pamoxis. One of the many corrupt Atlanteans, Pamoxis was one of just the worst, conspiring to straight up eliminate Aquaman for being the chosen hero. Pamoxis summoned Aquaman back to Poseidonis under the pretext of investigating a series of bizarre explosions taking place just outside the city. When the two went to investigate, Pamoxis pushed Aquaman into the path of a spiraling vortex, sending him backwards through time like 2,500 years. Returning to Atlantis, Pomoxis assumed Aquaman's appearance and identity, and told everyone that the real Pomoxis died in the explosions. With Aquaman's reputation, he was able to do pretty much anything and everything. However, he was eventually taken down by the real Aquaman after he returned to the present alongside Aqualad. A short time later, Pomoxis conspired with a pirate named Captain Clay, and together they lured a pack of sea monsters to attack Atlantis. While Aquaman and Aqualad were distracted trying to keep the monsters away from the populated areas, Pomoxis took advantage of the situation and staged a coup against the Atlantean king Stamar. His first official act as the newly crowned king was to imprison Aquaman and Aqualad. However, that did not last long because our heroes were able to dethrone him and just take him down. Check out his 4-issue run for yourself, starting with 1962's Aquaman number 3. That'll be it for this video, everyone. Know of any other Aquaman villains that haven't been in the spotlight for quite some time? Well, let us know in the comments below, and maybe we'll continue this list with a part 2 covering them all. If you haven't already, subscribe to Top 10 Nerd to stay up to date on all things nerdy, and while you're at it, why not ring that notification bell so you know whenever we upload a video. As always, my name is Jack, thank you guys so much for watching, and make sure to stay nerdy, my friends.